Good morning children, welcome to the online class. In this class we are going to learn about our first lesson, that is the universe and the earth. Previously we learned first lesson and second lesson of the world syllabus. Now we are in a new syllabus, revised syllabus for the academic year 21-22. Okay, so you should listen carefully this lesson. In this concept, in this the universe and the earth, in this class we are going to learn about environment. What is environment? Our environment, it includes all the living and non-living components. It works with that. It is the life supporting system. Because of this environment only we are able to live. It is providing us, it provides us the food, what we eat, and the water, what we drink, the air we breathe, and the land we live on. All these are able to get from the environment. This consists, it is a mixture of natural and man-made components. That means here we can see natural things and man-made things also. Okay, and this environment word is derived from the French word environ. What is that? Environ, which means a neighborhood. That means environment is nothing but our neighborhood. What we are observing in our neighborhood, that is only we will learn in this class, in this concept. Now we are celebrating, we are observing one day as a World Environment Day. That is a June 5th, we are observing this day as a environmental day. What is the objective behind observation of to make that day as environment day? To keep and to protect and to preserve our environment. We should not pollute it. So for the preservation of environment for the future generation, we are observing that day as a environment day. Now we will learn about the components of environment. Components of environment. What is there in this? Components of environment. Here we have three components. The first one is natural. The first one is natural. Second one is man-made. Second one is man-made and third one is human beings. How many components are there? Three components. What are they? They are natural, man-made and human beings. In this natural we have abiotic and biotic both. Abiotic and biotic. That means living things and non-living things, both will come under this. Man-made. In our surrounding, we see so many creations or constructions made by the man. Just like a road, buildings. All these are man-made, no? Industries, all this. That concerned this man-made. Human beings, individual, society. All this comes under human. Okay, now. First thing, natural environment. Natural environment. In this natural environment, it is providing us land and what do we live? That is comes under this natural. In this natural, we have land, water and air comes under this. Life also comes under this. It means in natural particularly we have the natural elements. In this natural elements of the earth comes under this. That only we call it as a natural dreams of the earth. Natural dreams of the earth. Under this natural dreams of the earth, we natural breeze. In this, first one is lithosphere. Second one, hydrosphere. Third one, atmosphere. Fourth one, biosphere. These are the natural rings of the earth. Now, first we will learn about the lithosphere. It is the solid part of the earth. Where we live on that? This lithosphere consists of different landforms like mountains, plains, plateaus, valleys. All this comes under here only. This lithosphere provides us the land to live, the land for agriculture, and the rocky material of this lithosphere provides us minerals for industrial development, and it also provides land for us for agriculture development. By that we can eat now, by that we can get food now. That's why it is the most important part of the our environment. In this environment, lithosphere, make this lithosphere for our use. And this lithosphere the land forms are divided into three forms. In this they are three forms. They are first order, second order, and third order. Whatever we are observing, different types of land forms, they divided into three types: first order, second order, and third order. In the first order we will get continents and oceans, and in the second order we get mountains, plains, and plateaus. In this third order we get meanders, deltas, sea arches. All this will come under third order landform. Okay, next one, hydrosphere. All the water bodies on this earth comes under hydrosphere. About two third are 71% of the 71% of the earth consists of 71% of the earth covered with water. But among this, only 1% of the water is only useful for drinking. Only 1%. Whatever the 2/3 or 71% of the earth covered with water, among this 1% only drinking water. 1% is only drinking water, and the remaining 99% in the form of snow or saline water. Means only little portion of the available water on this earth only is useful for drinking. Okay, only 1%, and the remaining 99% in the form of snow and saline water. Saline water means what? The water which is in oceans and seas, that comes under saline water. And not only the water which flows on the earth's surface, along with that some water is percolated into the soil, you know, that we call it as a groundwater. That also comes under this hydrosphere. In this hydrosphere we have ocean, rivers, lakes, ponds, wells, and streams. All this comes under this. Okay, in the next class we will learn about this atmosphere and biosphere. Thank you, children.